Hi guys, welcome to another episode of Learn Technology in 5 Minutes by MakerDemi.
This is Navi and part of the instructor team at MakerDemi.
In this episode, we will get a basic overview of what is quality of service in MQTT, why should you care about quality of service, and finally, learn how quality of service is implemented in MQTT. Let's relate quality of service with something that all of us can identify with. Let's imagine that we are in a traffic jam while going to a workplace. We will regularly be stopping and moving at a slow pace, but eventually we will reach our destination. Let's say while we are driving along, we hear sirens from the back. We look in our rearview mirror and we see an ambulance coming. What do we do? Yes, we all move over for the ambulance to pass. It is not a matter of life or death if we have to add a couple more minutes to our travel time. The same concept is useful in the world of networking. Basically, all data is not equal. Some data, like voice or video streaming data, needs to reach its destination as soon as possible, while a mail data need not. For such scenarios, we need a technology that controls and manages network resources by setting priorities for specific types of data on the network. This is where quality of service comes into the picture. We hope that you have already watched our video on MQTT protocol and also have a basic understanding of the TCP/IP model. If not, please go to the links in the description to get up to speed. By now, you would have known that MQTT is a machine-to-machine connectivity application protocol that runs on top of TCP. Even though TCP provides guaranteed data delivery, data loss can still occur. This is due to the fact that the internet protocol used in the network layer, like the IPv4, uses a quality of service model called best effort delivery, which does not guarantee message delivery nor acknowledgement to the sender on successful delivery. It is similar to a postal service. Thus, when the underlying transport of packets are unreliable, which is often the case with IoT devices, MQTT adds 3 quality of service levels in the application layer to ensure retransmission of messages and guaranteed delivery. This makes quality of service one of the most important features of MQTT. As MQTT is based on the publish-subscribe model, we will need to consider both the publisher-to-broker quality of service and broker-to-subscriber quality of service. For ease of learning, we will look at the quality of service levels from the publishing perspective. Now, let us take a closer look at the different quality of service levels available in MQTT and how they work. Quality of service level 0, QoS 0, is equivalent to the best effort delivery model as discussed earlier. In this quality of service, there is no guarantee of delivery as there is no acknowledgement nor retransmission by the sender. QoS 0 is used in the following two conditions. 1. Data is sent at very short intervals, thus loss of some messages are acceptable, like in weather monitoring or pollution monitoring systems. 2. You have a complete stable MQTT connection and no chances of disconnected clients are possible, like connecting to an MQTT broker over wired connection. Quality of service level 1. QoS 1 guarantees that a message is delivered at least one time to the broker. The publisher stores the message until it gets an acknowledgement packet within a predefined time interval. If the time interval is expired, the publisher republishes the message again to the broker. It is possible for a message to be sent or delivered multiple times in QoS 1. So when should you use QoS 1? 1. Your application must receive every message provided the application can handle and filter out duplicates, like in the case of a smart attendance system. 2. Your application can't handle the overhead of quality of service 2 but needs reliable message delivery. Quality of service level 2. QoS 2 guarantees that each message is received and only once it is received by the intended client. In this case, the guarantee is achieved by a 4-part handshake between the client and the broker. Because of this, it is the slowest method to send the message. In this QoS level, the publisher sends the message to be published to the broker and waits for the acknowledgement. When the publisher receives the acknowledgement message, it then sends another acknowledgement message back to the broker. When the broker receives this message, it will forward the published message to its subscribers. Next, the broker will send a publish complete message to the publisher. When it receives this message, the process is complete and it can delete the message from its outbound queue. QoS2 is used in critical applications where duplicate delivery can harm the application users or clients. For example, in accident detection, aircrafts, oil and gas plants, etc. That is all, folks. If you like this video, smash the subscribe button and ring the bell to be updated about our future video releases.